In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and warm welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's readings. It's the 15th of October, Tuesday of the 28th week in ordinary time. And today we celebrate the memorial of Saint Teresa of Avila, or she is also called Saint Teresa of Jesus, a Carmelite virgin, reformer of the order, and also a doctor of the church, a great mystic. The Holy Gospel according to Luke chapter 11 verses 37 to 41. At that time, Jesus was speaking. A Pharisee asked him to dine with him. So he went in and sat at table. The Pharisee was astonished to see that he did not first wash before dinner. And the Lord said to him, "Now you Pharisees, cleanse the outside of the cup and of the dish, but inside you are full of extortion and wickedness. You fools! Do not he who made the outside make the inside also? But give for alms those things which are within, and behold, everything is clean for you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Today the church celebrates the memorial of Saint Teresa of Avila, Carmelite reformer and mystic whose life of prayer enriched the church during the 16th century counter-reformation. As a child, Teresa felt captivated by the thought of eternity and the division of God granted to the saints in heaven. As a child, Teresa felt captivated by the thought of eternity and the vision God granted to the saints in heaven. Teresa was a woman for God, a woman of prayer, discipline and compassion. Her heart belonged to God. Her conversion was no overnight affair. It was an arduous lifelong struggle involving ongoing purification and suffering. She was misunderstood, misjudged, opposed in her efforts at reform. Yet, she struggled on, courageous and faithful. She struggled with her own mediocrity, her illness, her opposition, and in the midst of all, she clung to God in life and in prayer. Writings on prayer and contemplation are drawn from her experience, powerful, practical, and graceful. She was truly a woman of prayer, a woman for God. Teresa Teresa was a woman for others. Though a contemplative, she spent much of her time and energy seeking to reform herself and the Carmelites, to lead them back to the full observance of the primitive rule. In herself, in her prayer, in her life, in her efforts to reform, in all the people she touched, she was a woman for others. A woman who inspired and gave life. Saint Teresa is the master of prayer in the church. Above all others, she is the one who lays out the way of the spiritual life most clearly and most succinctly. The whole movement of the spiritual life is to go deeper into the soul until one finds perfect union with Jesus Christ, who dwells at the very center of our being. That is what her writings are about. And she teaches us this way, which was shown to her by the Lord Himself. She did not keep it for herself, but rather she has written it all down under obedience to teach the church, so that all of us would be able to walk the path that has been blazed for us. Teresa describes prayer in this way. As I see it, mental prayer, in my opinion, is nothing else than an intimate sharing between friends. So prayer is nothing else than an intimate sharing between friends. It means taking time frequently to be alone with him who we know loves us. It means taking time frequently, not only in the morning and in the evening, but taking time frequently to be alone with him who we know loves us. Saint Teresa, my dear friends, speaks about three virtues as necessary for the life of prayer. Which are they? Love for one another, detachment from all created things, and true humility. While these are the main, there are other supplementary virtues needed for a prayer life. In Teresa's opinion, if we wish to learn to pray, if we really want to make our life a journey of prayer, and vice versa, we must first lay solid existential foundations, for without them, prayer does not exist, or at least not in the form and way as taught by Saint Teresa. Just as a plant requires a proper environment and conditions to grow, so also in the spiritual life. One cannot grow in prayer and contemplation without the proper atmosphere of a virtuous life. Prayer requires virtues, and virtues facilitate contemplation. Are we ready to set out on this journey? Do we cultivate these virtues and those mentioned by Lord Himself? Let us pray. Brothers and sisters, today, as we find in the Bible diary, Kimberly Ann D'Souza from Dubai, Benlin Elvisha Lobo from Omsur, Mangalore, are celebrating their birthday. We wish them happy birthday and we pray God's choicest blessings on them. It's also the death anniversary of Dennis Pinto from Puttur. May the Lord grant him eternal rest. Spray the prayer, Saint Teresa herself wrote. Let nothing disturb you. Let nothing frighten you. All things are passing away. God never changes. Patience obtains all things. Whoever has God lacks nothing. God alone suffices. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Wish you all a happy feast of Saint Teresa of Avila, and don't forget to whisper a prayer for all the Carmelites today. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.